In this video, we're going to talk about the molecules that make up cells, specifically carbohydrates. As stated in the previous video, life and non-life are made out of the same atoms. What makes them different from each other is how these atoms are organized into molecules, and a specific category of molecules which are essential for life are the macromolecules. These are polymers, meaning long molecules made up of connecting smaller pieces together. Each of the four types of macromolecules are polymers made up of monomers linked together. While they're all linked by covalent bonds, it is the monomers which make these macromolecules different from each other. So it's not necessarily the types of bonds connecting the monomers, but the actual monomers themselves, the building blocks, that make these different macromolecules different from each other. Also noted in the previous video, the chemical reaction for building up macromolecules is known as dehydration synthesis, whereas the chemical reaction for breaking down polymers back into their individual monomers is known as hydrolysis. So the first type of macromolecule that we'll talk about are the carbohydrates. Now, simple sugars are carbohydrate monomers. These monomers are used in cells to store and release energy. So we call these carbohydrate monomers monosaccharides. And that prefix mono means one or single, whereas saccharide in this case is referring to sugar. So monosaccharides, they are the simplest of the sugar molecules. The structure of a carbohydrate are rings of carbons, hydrogen, and oxygen atoms. Glucose is one of the most common monosaccharides. It is common energy for almost all types of cells. It's also one of the products of photosynthesis. The general chemical formula for glucose is C6H12O6. So we see carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen atoms all included into the molecular formula for glucose. As we can see, glucose is much larger and more complex than smaller, simpler molecules like water or carbon dioxide. In part, the chemical formula of glucose informs us that it is an energy-rich molecule. If we take two of these monosaccharides and link them together using a covalent bond, the resulting molecule is known as a disaccharide. And there are some common disaccharides which have biological relevance. Lactose is an example of a disaccharide. It's made up of two sugars, glucose and galactose. Sucrose is a disaccharide. Sucrose is common table sugar. This is the sugar that you use for baking or that you put into your coffee. Now, if we don't just stop at two, but instead we link more and more and more of these monosaccharides together, the resulting molecule is known as a polysaccharide. With the prefix poly meaning many or several. So a polysaccharide is made up of a chain of many monosaccharides linked together. This can range from 50 all the way up to 500 or 5,000. These polysaccharides can be very large. So in this diagram, we see monosaccharide, a single sugar, like glucose, a disaccharide, like sucrose or table sugar, which is made by linking glucose and fructose together, and then also a polysaccharide, which will be a long chain of monosaccharides. There are three different types of polysaccharides. The first of these that we'll discuss is known as glycogen. Glycogen is a type of polysaccharide which is commonly made by animals. It can be digested easily, and it is used for short-term energy storage reserves in an animal's body. In humans, the most common area for glycogen to be stored is within our liver. However, glycogen can also be stored within our muscles. A similar polysaccharide, but one that's made in plants, is known as starch. As with glycogen, starch is easily digestible. It can be a great source of energy, both for the plant or also any animals or other organisms which consume that plant. So it is a polysaccharide which is commonly made by plants. It is used for energy storage within the plant's body. Here we see a diagram of a farmer working in a field. As this farmer is picking potatoes, we can zoom in on several different structures that are in view. Within the farmer himself, his muscles are storing this polysaccharide of glucose molecules known as glycogen. This could be the result from his dinner the night before, maybe even breakfast earlier that morning. The potatoes themselves are filled with the polysaccharide starch. This is why, as humans and other animals consume potatoes, we're able to get energy from that particular vegetable. Now, there's a third type of polysaccharide, one that's made exclusively by plants, and one in which is not easily digestible. This is known as cellulose. Cellulose is indigestible. For almost all animals, it is produced by plants, and it is the major component of plant cells' cell walls. It is what helps give plants their structural integrity. And it is also referred to as dietary fiber. So even though cellulose cannot be digested by humans or by other animals, it still becomes an essential part of our diet, something that we should receive regular quantities of in the food that we eat. It aids with digestion and can also be used by microorganisms that are living within our digestive system. When we look at cellulose and starch, again, these are both polysaccharides made by plants, but one of them is digestible and the other one is indigestible. One of them is used for structural stability within the plants and are a major component of the plant cell cell walls. That's the cellulose. Whereas the starch, it's not part of the structural setup of the plants, but it is energy storage. It is one way in which the products of photosynthesis are stored in the plant until that plant needs it at a later time. This includes our discussion of carbohydrates. Next will be a discussion of nucleic acids.